I'm here with Jennifer Hayden, who wrote a book called The Story of My Tits. And that's a really crazy title, but it's both funny, but also a very touching story. As you go through the arc of what it means as a female body person to have breasts, what led you to decide to draw and write the story?
I had been through the experience of having breast cancer. I'd had a bilateral mastectomy. I'm fine now. I had BCIS. It was early stages, but the breast cancer was in my family, and I wanted to deal with it aggressively, and I didn't want to have follow-up therapy. So anyway, I ended up going through this experience. Right after it was over, I wanted to write about it for other women who were about to go through it or going through it. And I had done writing, and I wasn't happy with my writing. And I decided I would find a new way to do it at exactly the same time I was recovering from breast cancer. I began reading graphic novels. I had just found out about them, and I was looking at these things and going, oh my God, this is perfect. Because I had been an artist as a child, and I'd done art history in college, and then when I left college, I had done fiction writing for many, many years. But I wasn't ever happy with either thing alone by itself. And when I discovered graphic novels, I realized, oh my God, this is the way to do it. This is not too many words, and it's... And then the amount of, the range of emotion that I find is possible in a graphic novel when you have both the pictures and the words, and they're working with each other and sometimes against each other. You get tensions going, and things become clear that no other medium for me can do. So I absolutely knew that this was how I was going to tell this story.
Well, one of the things that I love as I was looking through your book is that you're really making full use of the comic medium. There's a lot of visual puns in there, and kind of literal, kind of taking how you feel and really showing it. You know, there's a part where, you know, someone, it almost looks like she's drowning, you know, and it kind of shows how you feel on the inside. And that's something that you can write the words in a novel or a biography, but it doesn't really come across the same. I can really feel the way that you felt in that, you know, in that time.
Well, that was the main thing, I guess, that I've always wanted to do as an artist, was absolutely remove the distance between myself and any viewer or reader. I want to give my full experience of life to the person who's holding my artwork in their hands or my writing. And I was frustrated by writing because it wouldn't do it completely. And I remember when I started doing comics, one of my thoughts was, wouldn't it be cool if I could turn myself inside out, if I could give my emotional landscape, make it physical, make it visual. And you can actually take a look at that. I have a couple of panels that are, you know, like this. Surrealism is a period in the story. I'm in my 20s, and everything seems very alienating and strange. And I have sort of Salvador Dali and a couple of artists talking to me with representations of their artwork. And those artists were talking to me at that time, and I did feel as though that was my emotional landscape. And it was burned because I was starting over with my identity. Right. This book is very much about the development of my identity. And because it is about that, it makes sense to have so much emotional stuff. But I want to emphasize that I think everyone has felt this. I think everyone has gone through this. This is the construction of a person. It's all of us have gone through this. So it's not that my emotional landscape is so startlingly amazing. You know, it's that there is no difference between me and you. That's what I want to convey.
So one thing that I was curious, given the subject matter of the book and the fact that it essentially climaxes in your breast cancer part of your story, how is your feeling that your identity as a female-bodied person has changed? You know, your identity being expressed as, you know, your breasts and people noticing it. You know, you were talking about how all of a sudden boys were noticing you and so on and so forth. Have you evolved in seeing what having breasts means about being a woman?
Yeah, I mean, it's really funny. I was so obsessed for so many years growing up when I was flat-chested with having them. Now, honest to God, I look at breasts as these pills of dangerous fat. And I don't admire them. I used to go, oh, look at those, because my dad was really a boob man, and you know, and I really thought women's bodies were so beautiful. And now I have to say it's, and I don't feel as though I need those breasts to be a woman, but part of that is because I'm married, and my husband's been through this whole thing with me. He's known me from when I had a decent body till now, and you know, one of the epilogues in the book is about me having my gallbladder removed. I had a gallbladder attack that was horrifically painful 4.5 months after my mastectomy surgery. Yeah. And you gotta understand how funny that is. That is so damn funny, because here I am thinking that I'm finally eating well, I'm exercising, I've got rid of the cancer, everything's, I'm doing, living perfectly, and suddenly I end up having to go to the hospital to have my gallbladder removed. And I'm packing for the hospital, and I'm like, well, at least they're taking something I don't want.
Yeah.
But I came home, and I said to my husband, and I'm sort of like this, and I said to my husband, so do I look any different now that my gallbladder's out?
I love that. And I, you know, it's, there's definitely something that's so true about how being in a relationship really changes your self-worth in a way. You know, it's like, oh, there's somebody that finds what I look like attractive. And obviously there's some danger if too much of your self-worth is in that, but it can provide a safety net, I think, you know, where you have validation that, hey, it doesn't matter what my body shape is, or, you know, for a woman, breast size or anything, there's always someone that's going to find you attractive, you know?
Well, it makes you start realizing, okay, so who am I? I'm not this, but who am I? I must be something else.
Right.
But it's, as a woman, it can be hard to reach that moment, although I think that is part of growing up as
right.
a female and reaching a certain age. You know, you just, you're...
Jeremy and Kathy, if you can hear us.
That identity is shifting.
It takes a
lifetime to make that shift.
Sure. So is there anything else you want to talk about, either your other book, Underwire, or anything else?
No, I'm just very grateful to readers who've responded so positively, and to people like you who show interest, who are not my typical demographic. I'm very encouraged that so many men have picked up the book and found something in it, and I really hope that it leads to more people understanding this whole... the whole breast cancer issue and how it affects different people in different ways, relationships, how to be supportive, how to not be supportive, you know, and I hope that it's, and I also hope that it really encourages other people to do books like this, because I want to read them.
Cool. That's a great ending. Thank you so much. Thank you for speaking with me.
Thanks very much.